Hey everyone, it's Jen. I'm back and I haven't been here for a few minutes. It's been 6 months since I put up a video. I have not been active on YouTube, but I have been active on social media, especially Instagram. I put up all my book reviews and coloring pictures up there still. And I wanted to come on and just see how you guys are doing. I know there's not as much interest in the coloring like there used to be. It's not as popular, but some people do still watch. Actually, I've gotten quite a few people send me private messages lately asking me where I've been and am I going to put up YouTube videos again because they miss them. So I thought I would show you some of the pictures that I've done recently and then just talk a little bit about where I've been, what happened, and what I think I'm going to do going forward as far as posting and all those kinds of things. So I don't have these in any type of order. I just figured I would show them to you as probably by season, because that's really what I've done is seasonal pictures. So at the beginning of maybe September, I got this book. This is Wildflower Folk. And this is by, I don't know who this is by, Christine Caron? Yes, Christine Caron. And I got this on Amazon. This is printed by the same people who print the Jasmine Beckett Griffith coloring books. Yeah, I'm sure you guys are all familiar with this one. This is an oldie but a goodie. Hello, and I dropped it. This is by Blue Angel Publishing. So this one book was printed by them. It seems like her new books are still printed on the Amazon, so I don't know what's going on. I don't know the story behind why this was printed on this one, but when I saw this was printed in a nice book, I really wanted to get it. And I ended up doing this picture. Oh, I did it the day before my birthday. So clearly, I was in the fall season already. Obviously, I get into the fall season around July 5th. So right after the fireworks, it's all fall for me, and I did this one, and I used Prismacolors on this one. I don't know if you can see the leaves, but there's some glitter on the leaves just for a little accent. And then, you know, her nails, sorry to hit the camera. Her nails are glittery like mine. You'll have to forgive me. It's been, like I said, 6 months since I made a video or did any kind of talking or anything like this. So I'm a little rusty. So I'm gonna get back into the groove of things. But yeah, so I worked on that one. Another one that I did, this was the Halloween special, and this is like a magazine. So you know how the other ones have like here, let me just take my receipt out of there. So you know how the Coloring Heaven is like it's like almost like a paper cover, and they're bigger, as you can see. Well, I don't know if you can see, but they are a little bit bigger than this Halloween special edition that was put out. I love this. I actually bought two copies of this because I love the pictures, I love what they chose, and I decided to do one of my favorites. Carla Mangana actually was able to contribute a few pictures into this magazine. Unfortunately, my pages have fallen out, but this is another one. This is from Belle Pipistrel, I think. I don't know what this one is from. Spooklets. So I chose to do this one. I wrote on the back what I used. Prismas, Holbeins, and Polychromos. And I also used some Renaissance watercolors. So the gold and her gloves and the eyes of the pumpkin and any other thing like that that's like a metallic paint, those are from those Renaissance. And there is a marker base down on this one, and then of course Stickles. So chose to do that one. It's the only one I actually did out of this book. But again, this book, I love. I have two copies of it. Of course, I can make copies because I have a copier, but I like that a lot. And I got that. And you know what? Barnes & Noble still has copies of that. So if you're interested, you can probably find it there. Then I got a copy of Carolina Kubikowska's new book. So usually her books historically have been spiral bound. This one is a hardcover. I love her stuff. Even though it's a little odd, I still love it. And I was willing to pay the shipping on it. And I did this one. I did this one July 18th. So these are all posted on Instagram. You may have seen them already if you follow me there. Instagram is so weird that, you know, unless people are like regularly commenting on things, you don't see people's stuff and like unless you actually go look for it. So that's why I decided to come on and do this, because I know a lot of my coloring friends and reading friends follow me there, but like I said, if it's not in the algorithm and you don't put up too much stories, you're not going to see it. It doesn't, like, your posts don't really show up, unfortunately. So I thought I would come and show these things here. Plus, you can see the glitters and the paints and stuff much more. I don't know what I used on this one. I did write it down. Prismas, Polychromos, and Holbeins. I guess I was on a roll. And I know that the paint, see that, like, paint around the magic or whatever, that is that Renaissance. I think that was from the Christmas one last year. And of course, you know me, Stickles. All right, and then I did something out of Sager Ochsner. So if you didn't know the good news, Emily Leithold Oberg is going to be having this reprinted by, I believe, an American publisher. I want to say Smith Gibbs, but I'm not sure if that's who it actually is. But no, I don't think it is. It's another company that picked it up that's going to be publishing it. And I don't know yet when, but they're republishing it and she's going to have 8 new pictures in it. I'm definitely going to order a copy because this book is so, everybody wants this book. And if you didn't get it in like the first or second publishing, you never got it because they stopped printing it and she didn't have it reprinted. And Color with Claire here on YouTube started a petition to get it reprinted, and then a publisher picked it up and it's going to be reprinted. So that's really exciting. Definitely ordering a second copy. This is like probably my most prized coloring book besides my very first one, that was like hardcover that my brother got for me when I first got into coloring, which is, what's her name? Clara Markova's first book. But this is probably my most prized one. I have a lot of pages done in this one. And unfortunately, my Santa Claus, I don't know, got ruined somehow. Something must have fallen on it, some water or something like that. And I did this back in 2016, and that's what happened. So, I mean, not a horrible tragedy, but it'll be nice to get it reprinted, and then I can have another one and redo it. But like I said, I've done a lot of pages in this one, and this is the one that I chose to do for Christmas this year. I did this on November 11th, so only a few days ago I finished it. And it's just all different stuff. So, guess what I used? Polychromos, Prismas, and Holbeins. And I have chalk pastel in the background. I have the Renaissance paint on anywhere that you see the metallic color glitter type thing. Of course, Stickles. And really, really, really enjoyed working in this book. I work in this book only sparingly because, as we know, you can't get another one, but soon we will. For those OGs of the Reading with Pugs channel, you'll recognize these pictures. I've definitely had my share of coloring and showing in this book. But for those of you that haven't seen them, I'll just do a quick flip because, like I said, it is one of my favorite books. This is one of my favorite pictures I've done. I really like that one. I really love this one. This one, I always remember I used on the e.l.f., the Derwent pencils, those like nature type colors. I don't know what they're called anymore. But there's such a difference because I've colored in this over the years from when I first started coloring like 2016 till now. And I love looking through it because it shows me the different things that I've done over the years. Does that say 2013? That can't be possible. Is it? Or is it 2018? I don't know. I really don't know. I couldn't because I didn't color before Amelia was born, so that's not possible. So it's probably 2018. I remember doing like a cozy coloring night, and Sammy did this one on her live stream. It's really cool for me, actually. I don't know if this happens for you guys when you're looking through old pictures or old books and things that you've worked on, but other people obviously have worked on those kinds of things too. Or the same pages at different times, and you've watched videos, and it sparks a memory of different times and different things that you've done. And I love that kind of thing because it's just like certain times in life that it just sparks your memory. And this book, like I said, this is probably one of the best examples of my coloring throughout the years. You could see, you know, where I didn't use any stickles at all, to wearing, using lots of stickles and not doing backgrounds, to doing backgrounds. So this really shows my range of coloring and how I've learned to do things over the years. And like I said, one of my prize books. So that's enough about that one. I have some other ones. This is my like free pages book that I keep everything that's printed out. I have another gigantic binder, which I went through a long time ago, but I have run out of room in that. So I got me a Trapper Keeper for my kids back in the 80s. My friends that were kids in the 80s had a Trapper Keeper. I got me one because there was no way I wasn't having a new one. I loved my Trapper Keepers. So I keep my coloring pages in it. And this next page is from this little set by Mystic Art Mirrors called Cute and Creepy. I believe this is on sale on her page right now. She has, I don't know if it's 20% or is some sort of percentage off her, I think it's her whole Etsy store, but the ones that you can print out yourself, and I think you can get it for like $3 or $4. And the pictures are so super cute. I did this one in October. Let's see if I wrote down what I used. Luminance and Ohuhu markers. So obviously I switched out for this one. And also this is the Renaissance metallic on the candles and on the moon. And it's, I think it came out really cute. I was happy with this and I enjoyed working on that during the Halloween season. And then these are just some of the other pictures that come along with it. I didn't get to actually do any of them, but I really like the pictures that come in this set. She has a set out for Christmas right now. I'm gonna wait and see if she comes out with another one. I'm not like super thrilled with the pictures like I was with the Halloween ones. So I'm gonna wait and see if she comes out with another one. Because I do have some of her pictures from another set that I bought years ago. And then Deborah Muller came out with a little set of just like little things, like one with pumpkins, one with like spiders, one with girls. And I did the one page with the girls. So we have Wednesday, or at least I made her into Wednesday, Bride of Frankenstein, a spider, a devil girl, a doll, and a shoe, and other little things. And lots of stickles and funness. I enjoyed coloring that too. And I did that one in August. All right, another one that I did for the Halloween season was from Deborah Muller. This is from Rotten Girls. I did not get to very many of hers this year, unfortunately, because I just really didn't color that much. I don't color as much as I used to. I still color, but just not as much because I do split my time between coloring and reading. But I worked on this one. This was Prismas, Luminance, and Ohuhu markers. I did this one on October 14th, and I made it into a little me and Snowy. So, lots of stickles. Anything that is metallic is from Renaissance. And I used markers and pencils. And this dog had spots on it like a Dalmatian, but I just covered over them. I think you could see it if I hold it closer. And I made it into a Snowy, which I used to make all the dogs into pugs. So, there you go. So, that's that. And then the one that I just completed most recently is from the Nelko Neko book, the cat book. You guys know I'm not like a huge fan of cats, but I had a cat for a while, Nermal, which I don't know, he disappeared, but he was an outdoor cat that I was feeding. He would come every day. I haven't seen him in months, but I like this book a lot, regardless of, you know, how I feel about cats, although I'm having a sweeter spot in my heart because of Nermal. I had to have this book because it's so cute. I would call it the Thanksgiving picture. There's actually not too much stickles on this one. I think just on the berries and his hat. And then this has some like glitter on the corn. But I don't think I wrote down. No, I did not write it down. There's no markers on this because these are double-sided. I want to say this is Polychromos and probably some Prismas. Maybe some Luminance. This one I did last year around Halloween time. This was the first one I ever did in here, and I think that's it. I don't think I've done anything else in this book. But yeah, that's that. I do like the Christmas pictures that they have in there. Should I show you the Christmas pictures? The Christmas pictures are very, very cute, and I definitely could see myself coloring some of the Christmas pictures in here. So There's quite a few. I think this one is a double page spread. You can see that. And then we have, this one I don't think is a double page spread. I think it's just two separate Christmas pictures. This looks like stuff, you know, like Christmas stuff. And then this is an actual like picture of them decorating the tree, which is so cute. And then she's like in a toy chest. There's a nutcracker there. I guess it's the story of the nutcracker because that's what this looks like to me. Here's another double page spread. I got this, I believe, I want to say on Etsy. So if you're interested, yeah, that's where I got that. So I definitely am considering coloring one of the Christmas pictures from here. And then what I'm currently working on, so I don't know what year. I wish they would put the year on these things. No, I don't even know what issue this is. Oh, issue 10, Christmas Compendium. Again, I don't know what year this is from. I wonder if it says inside. Some of them you can still order. This one I feel like you can still order from their website. Some of them sell out fast and some of them you can still order. Hold on, I have some notes in here with dates and things I don't remember, so I won't read that. Don't know the date. Sorry. But this is the one I'm working on. This is from Micah Jelena. I've worked on a few of her little, I think these are like the minis. I'm not sure though. But I actually started coloring this one with Bic markers because my son was using my alcohol markers. So I got to do her skin and her hair with the alcohol markers and then he took them. So I wanted to do more of marker on her. So I took out my Bics because I haven't used, not Bics, no. No, what are those things called? Sorry about that. Not Bics, Sharpies, those little really tiny Sharpie markers. I had a whole bag of them sitting on my coloring cart. My coloring carts were a mess and my stuff was all a mess. And I was like, this is easy. I can access this. So that's what I used. So that's why it's a little, what do you call that? Like choppy on her dress, but that's okay because I'm going to go over it with pencils and we will fix it up and make it perfect. But it was nice coloring with those because I haven't used them in such a long time. And I hate that I'm worried about because I don't use my stuff as often as I used to, that my stuff is going to dry out. So I got to use those and I just have to do the pencils on this and then she will be moving. I haven't colored anything else in here yet, but I'm trying to make use of these because I often buy these and then never color in them. So I'm going to be working on that one. So what I think I'm going to do actually is I want to talk to you a little bit about things that have been going on. So I think I'm going to do some sort of a color and chat in this. I will color that little girl, get out my pencils, set my stuff up, and then we'll get to coloring and we'll talk a little bit about what's been going on. So hold on a second, I'll be right back. Sorry, forgot to show you one. This is from the Halloween Jasmine Beckett Griffith. This is the Angel de los Muertos. And I didn't want to do all the backgrounds and stuff that she had in there originally, so I painted it out and I just wanted it to really focus on her wings because I had a vision that I wanted to do with the wings. So I think it came out pretty good. I really like her hair. It's hard to do black hair and I really felt like I did an okay job with it. So there was that. And then I did try to copy some of her colors for the flowers on the bottom and then the sugar skulls. So this is another one that I did and I'm happy with it. I started working on this one and I like started it like a day or two before Halloween and then we all got sick and I was sick on Halloween and it sucked. I'm always sick on Halloween, but I painted out the background with like a black glitter paint. It's a black acrylic paint. And I started like her skin and stuff, but I'm going to finish this after Christmas. It's just like during the Christmas season, I feel like I'm in the Christmas spirit and I don't feel I'm in the Halloween spirit. I know that's weird because 11 other months out of the year, I'm in the Halloween spirit, but I don't feel it at this moment. So I have this in my to go back to bag and I will go back to this after Christmas when I'm more in the spirit to get back to Halloween. Okay, now for real, I'm gonna start coloring. All right, we are back. So I just made myself a cup of tea. So I have my, I don't know if you can see it, my Frosted Snowman mug, because 'tis the season. I also have my Stanley with my Grinch topper because I'm a drink goblin, and as you OGs know, the Grinch is my spirit animal. And I have my little tiny light here because I don't feel like setting up the big one, and this one is doing the job for now. So I'm gonna just start working on her hair and talk a little bit about like what's going on, where I've been, and why I took such a long break, and what I think is gonna happen for the future. So get cozy any way that you like to get cozy, and let's get started. So yes, I think the last time I put up a video, actually, let me take that back. I don't know when the last time I put up an actual like video. You know what I need? My glasses, because I can't see. Better. Okay, glasses on, activate. So the last time that I put up a video, I don't know when that was. I was putting up shorts. So if you watch the shorts on YouTube, I was putting up little shorts of finished pictures that I had done and book reviews. Wow, this is hard to do. I don't know how I used to do this for such a long time before, but this is not as easy as it used to be. Probably because I can't see it as well as I used to. And I'm used to sitting real close up to it now and not doing it like this. So we'll make it work for today. But I was doing that and it was going good. I was doing a Friday reads and coloring every week. I'm considering continuing to do that. So if you don't know where the shorts are, if you look at my channel and just look up the tab that says shorts, you will be able to see all the little ones that I've put up so far. I think the max is like a minute clip that you can put up. And I was doing those and I was enjoying it because it was just a Friday like update that I could just do real quick because, as you guys know, I work full time. So I do work from home. If there's anybody new here or you're not sure, I do work from home and I have for the last 20 years or so. But, you know, I still work, so I have to actually do work. And I don't have the time that I used to. And I know I've said this throughout the years, and it's just true. As your child gets older, you get a schedule, and you have to kind of live by that schedule, or things don't work out as well as they should. And now that he's in school, believe it or not, my friends, what was he, a few months old when I started making coloring videos? Well, he's in third grade now. So yes, EJ will be 9 in January. And he has, you know, we have a set schedule. And, you know, we have bath times and we have homework times because he definitely has homework these days. We have to, that's Snow White in the background making that noise. We have to do our reading for every night that he has to do for part of his homework. I cook dinner and we walk Snow White. Sometimes Frank will walk her for me if I'm cooking a big dinner and it's gonna take me a while. I've gotten really into, I can't say like really into cooking, but I try really hard these days not to order out because yeah, it's expensive. And when you go to the grocery store, it's expensive. And I feel like if I'm spending so much money at the grocery store, I mean, you pop into the grocery store for like just a few things and you're dropping $100. And I feel like if I'm dropping $100 in the grocery store just for a few things, I'm just gonna keep finding ways to make dinners out of things that I have in the house. And then we do our regular food shopping on the weekends. And that's basically what we've been doing. So if Frank's gonna be late, as he often is, because he has so much projects that he's working on, I will make dinner, walk Snow White first, and then come home, make dinner, work on the homework with Emilio. By then, usually Frank is home. Frank has like an hour commute to home. So he's not just right around the corner like he used to be when I first started making videos, which also makes a difference. Of course, when I started making videos, I had 3 dogs. Well, if you really want to go back into my video history, I only had 3 dogs because I used to make BookTube. I used to be just BookTube exclusive. And I used to just make book videos with my dog Belle, who was my soul dog. And then I had Emilio, and during that time, like soon after I had Emilio, I got into coloring, and then I started making both kinds of videos, and then I kind of just got into just making coloring videos. And now I make like vlogs, and I often was hosting a event called Marathon Your Hobbies Weekend. I would primarily host that on Instagram, and I would sometimes film clips for Instagram and for YouTube, but that got to be a lot because it's like double filming everything. So I kind of just started to keep that on Instagram. And then we had one a few months ago, and Anne Hatfield hosted with me, which was very fun. I enjoyed that. I actually happened to be very busy that particular weekend, and I couldn't participate as I wanted to, but I did what I could. But life's just busy, and I find that I have less and less time to devote to doing YouTube. And I was trying really hard a few months ago to really make that time. Like I said, make the shorts, do the updates on Instagram, and kind of just stay in contact through the shorts, because I know people really like short form content these days. Not everybody wants to sit for like an hour video. So I was really actually keeping up with that. And then in May, my mother-in-law unexpectedly passed away. My mother-in-law lived in Florida, and unfortunately, she just passed away, and we didn't know what happened, and, you know, she was found after a wellness check. So that's all I'm going to say about that, but we had to go down to her house unexpectedly in Florida. And we were there for a week, and we didn't expect any of that. We had to drive on down, and it was just, it like really threw a wrench into things. We had to go down and get all her paperwork. My husband, myself, Emilio, and then my in-laws. So my husband has one sibling, brother. And we all went down, both families, and we spent the week down there, and you know, it was a lot of work. It was like 12 hours of going through things and cleaning things out and making trips to the Goodwill, and I mean, we're still not done. And we will in the future, I don't know when, but we're going to have to go back down there to finish it up and put the house for sale. So that happened, and that was unexpected, and that really, I mean, that threw a wrench into things. It definitely made me contemplate things more, I guess I could say that. It was a shock, you know, nobody knew it was going to happen, and not that you usually know when that's going to kind of happen, but we didn't. And it was very spur of the moment. We have to go, we have to do this, we have to get it done. Then we had to come back and have, you know, the memorial service and the party, and not party, but like a remembrance, I don't know what you want to call it, memorial, and a mass and all that kind of stuff. So we had to do all of that, and it really kind of was overwhelming at some point, you know, going through all of her things. My father passed away when I was 12, and that was like the closest person to me. And besides my mom, you know, obviously, but I mean the closest person at that time who had passed away, and it was like different, you know, because I was a little girl. It's different when you're an adult and you're responsible for like getting paperwork and finding people's things and going through their things, and you know, it's just like a different experience. And it was I'm glad my in-laws were there, in other words, to do everything. We all did it together. I'm glad it wasn't just us. But it was something that we had to do. So that was at the very end of May. And we, like I said, we had been in Florida for a week. We took the dog and we drove down. And when we came back, Snow White was having some problems. She was having problems pooping, and she was straining almost if she was constipated. And We let it go on for a few days. As I figured it would straighten its way out, we started giving her pumpkin, which is what they recommend in those type of situations. And it didn't really help. And we were just trying to keep an eye on it and see like what's going on here. I mean, she was going, but it was taking a very long time. And then finally one afternoon, it took an hour for her to go and she was straining. And once she finally went, there was blood in it, and then she threw up because she had been straining so hard. And I said to Frank, we really have to take her to the vet. I don't know what, this is not normal. So we took her to the vet. I've been going to this vet for 18 years, so I really trust her. And she did an exam, and she said she felt like Snow White had a stricture, which is like a tightening of the butt gland, and she felt abnormal tissue. As soon as she said that, I knew what she was trying to say without her actually saying it. So she said we had to go to a specialist, and they would do a colonoscopy and determine what was going on there. So we made an appointment for the colonoscopy. We went to this specialist and he did an exam too, and he said he felt the same, but he did not recommend the colonoscopy. He recommended an MRI because then he could see better than he could with a colonoscopy, because he, I think he was saying like he could only go so far with the colonoscopy. So we said, okay, $3,000 later, she had the exam. And he called us a few days later and told us that Snow White had inoperable cancer and had only a short time to live because she also had cancer that spread to her lungs. Snow White's only 4. Well, she's 5 now. This was in July. Her birthday was just the beginning of last week. And they really didn't know how much time, but not a lot because the cancer was aggressive and it spread. He said he had done a biopsy and he was waiting for the biopsy to tell us what the cancer was, and then we would go from there. He told us that because surgery was not an option, that we could keep giving her the pumpkin, you know, because it was helping to a degree at that point. But he said if at some point she can no longer poop, we would have to humanely put her down. So this was all one phone call, a horrible, horrible phone call. This was in July that we got this news. So, excuse me. I still have the cough from hell. Emilio had it for 5 weeks. I still have it. And, it's better than it was. It was very like gross and mucusy. I don't even know what it was, but everybody around here is getting it. So just bear with me on the coughing. So back to Snow White. We were devastated. This is a horrible thing. Dog was 4 years old. And I called her vet. And, you know, she had gotten the report and she just said, I can't believe this. I really didn't expect it to be this. She's like, I thought it would be a tumor and that they would just do surgery and all would be well. And she's like, I'm just so sorry and let me know what we can do. They told us she wasn't in any pain at that time and that, you know, when the pain started, that they would take care of it and keep her comfortable until the end. And we both took the day off from work the day after we got this news. I mean, we were just devastated. We were just laying around with her. I was hysterical, crying all the time. I mean, this dog saved me after Belle passed. And I couldn't believe this. Like, how is this possible? My 3 pugs all died within 2 months. 2 of them died in 1 week. And those were my children, and I'm now being told my little young dog is not going to make it. So it was horrible. And I called her doctor, her vet, and I said, there's no way that like this could just be inflammation. And she said, and this was before I had gotten the results with the cancer. And she said, no. She goes, I know. She's like, anything's possible. She goes, but I really don't think that's what it is, especially because of the abnormal tissue. And I said, okay. So then we, you know, did the whole thing, got the biopsy, and all this happened. Well, no, actually, we got the results of the MRI. We were waiting on the results of the biopsy to find out what kind of cancer it was. Okay. So we're just kind of living life and, you know, talking about how long does she have? Nobody knows. What are we going to do? Obviously, we're going to get another dog because in my experience, that's been the only way for me to move on. I got Snow exactly 1 week after Belle passed. And everybody has to do them. So whatever a person feels that they need in order to move on, not move on, but in order to heal themselves, I think is what they have to do. Everybody's different. Some people don't want to replace them right away and they feel like, not replace them, but some people don't want to get another animal right away. They feel like they need to take time to grieve because that's the right thing to do. Some people run right out and get another one. And I was the run right out and get another one because I didn't know any way to make it better for myself and not lay in bed and just want to die because Belle's gone. So that's when we got Snow. And I was already talking to Frank, like how I couldn't get another dog. Like I couldn't bring another dog into the house while I still have Snow. I didn't want to do that to her. Especially because now she was sick. And I didn't know how I was going to do any of this. Like, I just didn't know how I was going to do any of this. I held Belle and Little Bear as they passed. Jack, unfortunately, had to be put to sleep because he was suffering. But I was with him. I never left him. I would never do that. I just... As hard as it is for a person to stay, I feel like it's just so important. They look to you their whole lives. And for me personally, I could never not stay because they were there for me for their whole life and I'm going to be there for that important moment. So I stayed with Jack. So did Frank. But the other two passed at home in my arms. And I was like, I knew that when Little Bear went, I still had Jack and Snow. And I knew that when Jack went, when I came home, I had Snow. And now I wasn't going to have anybody when it was her turn. And I just didn't know how I was going to deal with that. So there's all these thoughts and emotions going on. And, you know, it's hard because the dog doesn't understand why you're so upset and you're just cuddling her and spending every minute with her. And it was a lot. So 2 weeks later, after we had gotten the call about, you know, that she had the cancer, all that, her doctor that did the surgery and the biopsy calls back and I saw his number come up on my phone and I thought, oh great, here we go. Next call to find out like how long she has because they have the biopsy results. So he gets on the phone and he says, how's Snow doing? So I said, yeah, she's, you know, doing the same. And he said, okay, well, he goes, I don't know how to tell you this. He's like, I've gotten her biopsy results. He goes, and I looked at them. And I consulted with two more doctors. He said, I consulted with an oncologist and I think he said a radiologist. I don't know, it's been a while, so I don't remember exactly what he said. He said, but I have to tell you that Snow White does not have cancer. Well, you could have knocked me over with a feather. I said, well, what are you talking about? What does this mean? What does she have? Why is this happening? She has massive amounts of inflammation. Didn't I say that? I asked that at the vet visit. I asked him too when we brought her. And they told me, no, it couldn't be that. Friends, go with your gut. Because it could have saved a lot of heartache if I would have insisted that I cannot afford these vet bills to, you know, have the biopsy and all that. If I would have said I couldn't afford it, and we have to try to do something else, my vet would have gave me the steroid, and guess what? Snow White would have been fine. because that's how they ended up treating it, with steroids. And thank the Lord above, thank you Jesus, anybody that was listening, St. Francis, St. Jude, everybody that we prayed to, our prayers were answered. They had told us that after we had gone in for the initial visit, before she had the MRI and all that kind of stuff, they told us if it was a stricture, that she would have to have multiple surgeries to keep this open. So at the very least, after this first appointment, before she had had the MRI, the biopsy, we were under the impression that she's going to have multiple surgeries just to keep life going because of this problem. At the worst, it would be cancer. And when they called us back, they told us it would be the worst and that they couldn't operate on her. Now he calls me and tells me that she doesn't have a stricture, that she has just massive inflammation and the tissue is feels odd and looks odd because of the massive inflammation. So she needs no surgeries at all, and they're going to treat her with a special diet and steroids. And we don't actually feed Snow White dog food. We've never fed her dog food. I always feel like there's a lot of artificial things in dog food. You do you. You know, like, well, I'm not here to argue or debate with you. You do what you think is best for your pet, and that's what we do. We did feed the pugs dog food, but Snow White, we had decided straight out before we even got her that we were not going to feed her dog food. That's not true. Let me take that back. We started to feed her dog food. We had gotten her better dog food than what we were feeding the pugs. And we tried 5 dog foods with her, 5 different ones. And each time, no matter what we gave her, and we did the method of a little bit here, you know, scooping it in, mixing it in, no matter what we gave her, the dog had diarrhea. So for months, she had diarrhea. And, well, I shouldn't say months. For weeks, she had diarrhea, and they keep telling us, change the dog food, change the dog food, and we did it. And then finally, we had gone away after Jack had passed, and we brought Snow with us. And she was still a puppy. She was only about she was probably about 5 months old. And when we went away on this trip to Jamestown, we forgot to bring dog food with us. So we just gave her, like, eggs. Because, I mean, they always recommend if you want something, you know, if the dog won't eat, try to give them, like, eggs or chicken. So we gave her scrambled eggs. The dog ate the scrambled eggs. She ate bacon. She ate sausage. And she was a puppy. And at this time, she still had the diarrhea from all the dog food. We gave her all this food. And I thought, oh, man, she's going to have rancid diarrhea now after this. Guess what? No more diarrhea. So that's when I knew. I'm sorry about all the poop and diarrhea talk. It just happens to be an issue with this dog. But after all of that, I said to Frank, no, we're not going to give her dog food. It doesn't agree with her. Dachshunds notoriously have, like, very sensitive stomachs. I said it doesn't agree with her. And lots of people cook their own food for their dogs. So we just decided to start giving her chicken and vegetables. And that's what she's been on since she's a puppy. When we went to Florida, when my mother-in-law died, we don't give her dog food, so we didn't bring any with us, but we didn't have her normal food. So we were feeding her, like, chicken from the fast food and stuff like that, because that's all that we had available to us. So we were just trying to do what we could to feed the dog. We were getting, like, scrambled eggs for her from the Cracker Barrel and things like that. And I know it's not the healthiest thing, but the thing that happened with my mother-in-law was a split last minute decision, literally packed our bags and left the next morning. So it wasn't like we had time to prepare and cook all this food in order for us to bring it for her. It just would happen. And that's what set off the massive inflammation. Now, we wanted to follow what they were saying, but the doctor also told me that the steroid could cause her to get diarrhea. So I said, okay, so it got the steroid and it ended up constipating her. And I called him and I told him, and he said, there's no way. I was like, that's the only thing that she's doing. We didn't change the diet yet because you told me this might give her diarrhea. I said, so I didn't know what would be giving her diarrhea if I changed her diet and gave her the medicine. So we decided to just do the medicine first. So he was like, oh yeah, that's a good point. So I told him, I think we need to cut back the steroid a little bit. And he's like, no, just give her pumpkin and all this kind of stuff. Keep the steroid 2 times a day. Well, you know what, friends? After everything that happened here and all the bad information and advice that I had been given, I took matters into my own hands and I cut back the steroid to 1 a day. The constipation completely stopped. She got back to normal and we never changed her diet because I knew she'd been on this diet for 4 years. This isn't what did it. It was the food when we were down in Florida. And Knockwood, Snow White has been fine. The spots that they store on her lungs were granulomas, which is non-cancerous little growths that came from the inflammation. So this was basically the end of July when all of this stuff got sorted, and it took a lot out of us. It really did. It was like a roller coaster of emotions. And I told you all that because it was important to know like the background on this. And that's why basically I just stopped filming, because this all happened. Now I'm at the end of July, beginning of August. And I just wasn't in the mood to film. I felt like maybe coloring videos aren't relevant anymore. Maybe nobody cares about book videos. But I can see people are watching my videos. And then, like I said, I've gotten quite a few messages of people asking me when am I coming back. And they're watching my old videos for coloring tips or just for company when they're lonely or something to listen to. So I decided today, since I'm on vacation for Thanksgiving, that I would come back and just put up a video, let you know where I've been, and tell you that I think my plan for the future here is I'm going to put up videos, perhaps coloring videos like this one with updated pictures. I like doing the vlogging, so I am considering maybe doing more of those and some, you know, colors and chats sprinkled in as long as people are watching them. If they're not watching them, I'm not going to do them because I think that just makes good sense. And then I'm going to continue doing the shorts because I really like doing those. So the little short videos where I give just a short review, a short, not review, but well, review for the books, but a short little update on pictures that I've finished so that you can get those in real time instead of waiting for months. And then I can do longer videos, you know, in the time when I have the time during the month. So this is my goal for 2024, because I really tried to in 2023 do this. It was a goal. It was something I wanted to do. And then it just didn't work because of like circumstances with life, like things that I couldn't avoid. You can't really do anything about people dying and, you know, animals getting sick and all that. It's just like unfortunate things that happened in 2023. And I'm going to try my best to do this. So if you've stuck with me for this long in the video or this far after all of these years of watching my videos, I really appreciate it. I really do. You are the people that I do this for, the ones that want to watch, the ones that reach out to me and say, I miss you and, you know, I hope you put up videos. I understand if you can't. It's just really nice to know that there's still people in the community out there that are interested in this kind of stuff and do want to watch. My videos are not tutorials. They're not meant to teach anything. Basically, I'm just keeping my hands busy while we're talking here. And hopefully it keeps you company and you like it. And I hope that if you didn't know about the shorts, they're kind of like the reels on Instagram, if you're familiar with Instagram. I hope you'll go and watch those and that you enjoy those as well, because I can do those really regularly as opposed to doing like the whole setup. Another, you know, problem for me with doing all of this is I just don't have the quiet space anymore to do it like I did when Amelia was little. He very rarely just wants to sit and be quiet. You know, he's a growing boy and he's doing stuff and he's watching his iPad and he's playing games and he's, you know, running around doing his thing. And I just don't have the same place. Like, I'm not in the same place as I was when I started doing this. So I have to find a new way to do it. And I think this is the way that's going to work for me for now. Things always change. If there's anything that you can believe in life, it's that change is constant and things will change again. No doubt about it. But, this is my plan. I wasn't going to do it. I was just going to let it go and just say, that's it. I'm done. I disappeared. You guys can find me on Instagram because I'm very active on there, but I think I'm going to give it another go and we'll see how it turns out. So, I think that's going to be it for today. I have to go pick up Emilio from school really soon. And I have to take Snow White out. But I hope you've enjoyed this. I've enjoyed making it. It was really nice to be able to have a little bit of quiet time and just do this like I used to. And I hope you'll leave a comment and let me know what you think of the plan, if you'll watch the shorts, if you're still coloring, if you're reading. I hope you'll come over and see me on Instagram at Reading with Pugs, because like I said, I'm super active there. And it's just been a pleasure to hang out with you guys today. So thank you so much, and I will see you soon.